The Indian Space Research Organization said that India's high-power communication satellite GSAT-30, aimed at providing high-quality television, telecommunications and broadcasting services, was successfully launched on board Ariane 5 rocket from French Guiana in the early hours of Friday. Blasting off from the Ariane launch complex in Kourou, a French territory located in northeastern coast of South America, at 2:35 a.m. Indian Standard Time, European launch provider Ariane Space's Ariane 5 vehicle injected GSAT-30 into the orbit in a flawless flight lasting about 38 minutes and 25 seconds. ISRO tweeted soon after deploying the satellite into the transfer orbit. Confirming the successful launch, Ariane Space CEO Stephanie Israel too tweeted. ISRO's UR Rao Satellite Center Director P. Unnikrishnan, who was present in Kourou, congratulated the ISRO community and Ariane Space team on the successful launch. Calling it an excellent start to 2020 for ISRO with this launch, he said, the mission team at the Master Control Facility have already acquired the satellite and they will immediately complete the post-launch operations. The space agency said that ISRO's Master Control Facility at Hassan in Karnataka took over the command and control of GSAT-30 immediately after its separation from the launch vehicle, and preliminary health checks of the satellite revealed its normal health. In the days ahead, orbit-raising maneuvers will be performed to place the satellite in geostationary orbit, which is 36,000 km above the equator, by using its onboard propulsion system. During the final stages of its orbit-raising operations, the two solar arrays of the antenna reflectors of GSAT-30 will be deployed. Following this, the satellite will be put in its final orbital configuration. The satellite will be operational after the successful completion of all in-orbit tests. ISRO Chairman Dr. K. Sivan was quoted saying, GSAT-30 has a unique configuration of providing flexible frequency segments and flexible coverage. The satellite will provide communication services to Indian mainland and islands through Ku-band and the wide coverage covering Gulf countries, a large number of Asian countries and Australia through C-band. Well, it certainly is a great start to 2020. Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.